Remember in the Infinity Gauntlet where like Adam Warlock's main plan was just to distract Thanos so the Silver Surfer can try to steal it? But
that shit didn't work, man. That was the worst plan
ever. He wasted everybody's lives for that, dude, and that thing just got bodied.
Except for Captain America.
And the funniest part that always cracks me up is when they knocked the gauntlet off and then Doctor Doom was like, try to go for it right away, dude.
Yeah, what a fucking idiot. That was the worst idea ever. And Thor thought he was a badass. Oh, dude, not.
Hey, man, everyone thought they were badass.
Quasar got bodied. Cyclops got bodied.
Took all the bones out of Wolverine.
Yep. That's like the saddest death ever. He's turned him into rubber, man. What a bitch.
What a kitchen.
Just make the podcast about why the Infinity Gauntlet was a great arc. You know?
Hot, sexy girl following you on Twitter. Nice. All right.
Sounds like a real person to me.
Yeah, totally real. All right, man. I think we can, we'll give it a little go, a couple of minute or two to warm up this podcast. Fuck it, Tim's in here. That's all we need to know, man.
Nice.
So I guess this will be about, how about like a more of a, since the, Land Diego thing is still a, well, not really a hot topic, but it's a thing happening. And then I guess we'll do like a whole, a refresher of where to play in San Diego. And why, the pros and cons of each place, maybe. You know, this isn't, God damn it, it's him. So I guess we'll start right now. I mean, welcome everybody to the 15th episode of the TTF podcast.
15 already, huh?
And this is not counting the original, podcast back in the vanilla days, man. But this is 15 strong of the new ones, of the new era of the Marvel Universe, as you say. But today's topic is, are you afraid of the house? Which is basically...
the answer is yes.
The answer is yes. I asked K-Sexy, are you afraid of the house? You know, as a joke of this Photoshop. But then he told me his legit reason. And it was pretty funny. Yes. And I was pretty much, you asshole. But like I said, this will be pretty much a where to play, where and when to play in San Diego as soon as, this is the last week of the Salt Mines.
Yeah, hopefully see everybody there, by the way.
We'll talk about a lot, actually. Actually, now that I hear myself talking, there will be a lot of cool things to talk about in this podcast, and I hope you guys all enjoy it. So to start things off, fuck it. Let's just start off as a normal conversation. Vince, how was your day, man? How's your week going, dude?
Not too bad. Not too bad. That's all I got to say. Session yesterday. The good secret sessions that people we won't talk about, but there's a lot of people here. So far, so good. Can't wait for Saturday and Sunday. Hopefully it's a good time.
Yes. Okay. All right. Fair. Yeah. Not much going in the fight. Oh, actually, there's a lot going in the fighting game world.
There's a lot of stuff coming up. There's tournaments. They're big. They're coming up.
But yeah. Combo Breaker is this week, right? Weekend?
Combo Breaker is going on, and also Stunfest. That is going to be ridiculous.
What the fuck
all
is
the international
Stunfest?
Players are at Stunfest.
Where's that at? That's the first time I heard about Stunfest.
Yeah, in France. Like, pretty much anybody... who's anybody is going to be at that tournament that's international. So that's all right. Cool.
Oh, my teammate Aliyun will be there, AKA, I am the best.
Homie Smiliyun. Yeah. Smiliyun. You are a top player. Just some of the people there, just in case anybody is actually
interested.
Let's check
this. Let's just check this.
But it's everybody. So that's all you got to know.
Everybody and their mom. Josier. I already see the first six people. I don't know any of these people, but
keep going.
Dark Jaiway. Okay.
You got to get past all the France and all the weird countries.
America. I don't see no Americans.
Yeah, they're all Combo Breaker. But everybody else is there at this place.
Well, you know what? I can tell you one thing, that this is already past like 60 people, man. Holy shit. Oh, wow. I do have to get past all the French people. And that is like fucking... Dude, 292 people from France.
Yep.
And we got fucking Bass from Japan. Holy shit.
Hey, look at all the Japanese players there.
Momochi, Kazunoku, Daigo, Mako, Tokido. Who the hell is EBL? Who's that guy? Kappa?
Yep.
Who's that guy?
It's Ebi.
Who's he use? Never heard of him.
I don't know. It's Ebi, though.
Okay, Ebi. Who's the R Kappa guy? RF, the homie RF, Yeah.
Shouts to him making it out of that My Pool and Winners. That guy sucks.
Sataro Man, Banchan, Ite, Fudo, some guy named... Okay, I don't know who that... Some guy from Mexico is going, Norway. All right.
Yeah,
Infiltration, Punko. There are two Punkos. I don't know what that's all about.
Punko and Angry Punko. Yeah, both versions.
Okay, so blah, blah, blah. United Kingdom, any UK guys here? Is Ryan Hart going to be at this? The Prodigal Son? There he is. Was Luffy in the bracket? I kind of pranced the French.
Yeah, they're supposed to have that big money match, but apparently that's not happening.
Oh, with the Centauro Man? Was that the one? Oh, man.
Is that this? Or is that
a
different?
I hope that's at Evo. That's all I'm going to say, dude.
Yeah, they can't do it because of, like, weird international regulations or some reason. Whatever, blah, blah, blah. If it happens, it'll happen at Evo. Yeah.
Three-star. We got three people from the United States. I don't know who any of these guys are. And, wow, that's a lot of people in that tournament, man. That's kind of a... That's pretty cool, man. And then, of course, Combo Breaker is going on. And I'm pretty sure that's going to be a crazy tournament. Actually, wow, this is crazy. This is going to be, like, the first big major in America that Infiltration won't be at. So,
yeah, he's been at everything else. Yeah. Man, Jesus Christ. He doesn't have to go to anything else, but he's going to keep going anyway.
Well, of course, man. He's
a travel person, and he is a plan.
All right. So that's your events going on. Combo Breaker, the Stunfest. So thanks for tuning in to the podcast. I'll see you guys next week, man. No, I'm joking. Oh.
Yeah, bye-bye. Go fuck yourselves.
Go fuck yourselves. Let's see what we got here. All right. Let's get to the topic, though. Like we were saying, is,
Cool. And see you guys Saturday. Hopefully.
Combo Breaker, all that stuff. We'll get into what's going on the week later. But let's talk about, in reality, what's going on in San Diego and where and when to play. If we have any new people in the scene. And, you know, this will be nothing but a positive podcast, hopefully. You know,
so far so good,
I guess. We're all about positivity in the scene.
I'm done.
And we want more people to come out and, support these things, dude. And gotta work on the events, man.
Thanks for continuing to support the events, by the way. Yeah. You know who you are. Yeah. I don't have to keep saying your names every week, but
Will in the end. Let's just talk. Fuck it, let's talk about TTF, man. Well, fuck everything else right now. So Vince, can you tell me? Let's get some personal stories about your first experience at TTF. Can you tell me that?
Jesus Christ. We watched the first VHS with Rico, and he like wouldn't stop crying in the theater and freaking out and like yelling at people and trying to fight them. And then we decided, fuck it, let's go to this TTF place and see what's going on. And after that, it's pretty much just history. Everybody just played there, talked a lot of shit. We saw Nia for the first time ever. That guy's the best. And I don't know what else to say about it. It was a cool place. I would recommend it to anybody.
That's the podcast, guys, basically.
See you guys later.
Yeah. Enjoy the picture of this haunted house thing.
Good picture.
But I beat me. It was a little jiffy. There were a lot more people. Well, there's 10 people. I'm glad that are watching this. But I wish we had more people for questions about TTF. This would be like a Q&A about, if you're a new player in the scene, should you be scared of TTF? I mean, Vince, were you kind of like, this Cody guy or these TTF guys seem like assholes, I don't know about it. Or did, you just say, fuck it, let's go. They play Street Fighter. We all play Street Fighter.
That was pretty much it. I was like, hey, there's another place to play. Let's fucking check this shit out and see what's happening. We're already here. Fuck it, let's go. And all that was it.
Okay. So, yeah, basically, I can't really think about it because there's nothing but positives. I mean, if you want to play Street Fighter, there's places to play. There's not many places to play, but, there are places to play. And if you can't get past that, thing where it's like, oh, there's nowhere to play in San Diego, there's no point in playing Street Fighter. No, you got to get your head out your ass and get on the internet, on the SD Fight Scene page, and actually pay attention to these motherfuckers that say, hey, TTF on Friday, OFC on Saturday, blah 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 blah. You can't see these on the internet and fucking be like, oh, there's nowhere to play. Those are the people I hate. Early call out wall. Like, the people that always complain there's nowhere to play, but every day there's, someone spamming, they're playing games, or even playing online, man. Fuck.
If you have to. Last resort, but yeah. There's usually local stuff going on.
And, there are secret sessions in other places.
Secret places. That may not be secret in a couple months anyways, but we'll see where that goes, depending on how OFC turns out.
Yes. Vince, maybe that'll be a week or two. You can tell us. Maybe we'll make a podcast out of that. But, there are places that people do play. And if, in reality, these are houses, right? I can say these secret areas are houses. And in reality, you cannot invite 64 people in one house.
Be a fucking mess.
You can. And then, that's just a whole other story. That's me, though. I don't mind having all you fucking assholes in my house. And then the next day, me cleaning. Because that's just who I am and how I support the scene is this. Treat this house as an arcade, but in reality, you should be, respectful and stuff. But there are other people that you do realize that, hey, I can only have this amount of people, and if we're having sessions,
just hit me up and, you know, we'll play. And, or, like, they'll make an event page and, you know, it will be a private event page. But then the thing is, there are sessions out there and, you know, just got to know who to talk to. I mean, it's like the Illuminati. That shit's real. But, I mean,
yeah,
we're not dicks, though, man. It's just how it is, man. But Friday nights, dude, like TTF, dude, people got to know that we're coming back every Friday, man. There's still a fucking hole in my roof, you know. I mean, you know, people are questioning, should I fix my shit? But, you know, that's just,
you
want
to get base Lotheb out of there.
Yeah, you want to get the Lotheb, you know, the shrooms growing behind the puppet show. But, you know, that's just all personal shit. I mean, it's getting handled. It's getting handled in, like, in July, in the summer, you know. I mean, if you want to go into my personal family, you know, economic scales and all that shit. I'm more than happy to tell you, like, why it's taking so long. But, you know, we're not about that right now. All you got to know is that starting in May, June, that TTF will be open every Friday. And then we're going to start Low Rollers again. We're going to start stuff. I'm going to promise you that we're going to have PS4s. And we're not going to have 10 of them. We're not going to have 6 of them. But maybe by the end of June or July, we will have 3 PS4s at TTF. With that said, I just realized that at the end of this month, Ultra Street Fighter 4 is fucking coming out for the PS4. And then this is like
This is the
old days now. This is the vanilla days. This is any scene. I have to you got to rely on you guys to bring your sticks. You know what I mean? Like, I want to provide you with PS2 stick or PS4 sticks.
But in reality,
it's like, hey, you know what? I wish I can, but it's a possibility that I will get these sticks. Not anytime soon, but in the future, I want to have sticks for you guys. But I mean, hey, man, it's going to be weird because there's only a couple of sticks out and everyone's going to have their, you know, preferences. If I do buy 6 arcade sticks, we throw a tournament, there's always going to be that one guy's like, oh, I don't like this stick. I'm not feeling it. You know, I'm just not feeling the stick. You know, but hey, you know what I mean? Like, everyone at AI Super Arcade played on the whole, or back in the day, I would say, played on the same setup and we all, you know, you just dealt with it. That's how it was back in the day. That's how it was in the...
Sometimes
you
can't tech. Sometimes Fierce doesn't want to work every time, but you just deal with that shit.
Sometimes your one button, you know... Yeah, exactly. Sometimes the jab goes out, you can't get your tech in, and you lose the game. And the next round, it happens.
That's it. But you know what? Nobody gives a shit what happened. They'll fix it for the next person, but that game's already done. Yeah. It's over.
That's just how it was in the... You know, that's how it was, man.
Yeah, that was really how it was.
You press start, fuck, man. You lost, so you're matched, dude. It didn't even matter, because there's no start buttons in arcade, but whatever. Nope. You know, that's something else. So, what the fuck were we talking about, Vince? I was rambling on about.
You were rambling, but it's okay. It's fine. Talking about what we got at TTF.
Okay, yeah, we're talking about, 3 PM. Thank you, whoever said that. Yeah, I'm looking at the delay. Delay chat. And I'm answering it's bad. Tim's question 5 minutes early. Anyway, no, I can promise you those three setups, you know what I mean? But I can't promise you sticks, I'm sorry. I can promise you Marvel. I can promise you the 2 Marvel setups. I can promise you the 2 Ultra setups. I can promise you the 1 MK setup, you know what I mean? But what I can't promise you is, you know, the sticks.
The goddamn sticks.
The goddamn sticks. I can't promise you yet, you know what I mean? And, it's my choice. It's my way of life. It's my choice of me just spending my money on you guys. Not on myself, but on you guys. But if people have questions on the way I spend my money or anything, you're more than free to post about, you know, what your thoughts are. I mean, I want to thank everyone for the GoFundMe. I mean, I think I raised I put a number out there. I put four G's, 5 G's. I just put it out there. I knew for sure I wasn't going to get that much money. In the end, I didn't think I was going to get any money, man. You know what I mean? I might have just put $5 in there myself. To be like, hey, look at this guy, you know, he helped out to, like, start a fire, you know what I mean? But in reality, in the end, I made, like, $250. I did not expect to make $250, man. That was a new Xbox, and that was, like, half of a PS4 that I got. So, you know what? Those people that donated, and you know who you are, hey, dude, that money went straight to Secret Wars at comms and stuff, man. Thanks, but no. Yep. No, it went straight to a new Xbox and a new PS4, man. I mean, I don't have it now, but that's where it went. And I really, and you know, shouts to Paul, Polydactyl. He's donating an Asus monitor to us, man. You know, that's fucking awesome, dude. I can't wait for it. That's another fucking monitor that we're going to need for a PS4 anyway, right, man?
Yep.
Like,
It's just CRTs, man. That's just,
hey, you know what?
Think about it, man.
It's truly an end of an era at TTF, man. When it comes to CRTs, if you guys stuck to us with from the beginning, we were heavily based on CRTs because in reality, CRTs did not lag. Everyone had a CRT. That shit did not lag. But it's getting to the point where we can't play on CRTs no more because PS4 is, you know what I mean? Like,
that shit is just not possible.
It's not possible.
To downscale it is a piece of shit. So I looked into it. This shit is not real.
It's not going to happen, man. I mean, it's just, and the reality is that if you're going to have events, you're going to have a fucking, you're going to have monitors. But, you know, I got a message 4 hours ago from Paul. Hey, Cody, I've got an Asus V236 old EVO monitor that has a single dead pixel. It works fine, but that one pixel drives me nuts. Would TTF have any use for an extra monitor? I was thinking I'd donate it. And your answer, Paul, is fuck yes, dude. I will take that Asus monitor and I will sell it to Vincent for $700. No, I will take it and use it for TTF. And that would be a whopping 3 meters, guys. For
3 meters.
3 monitors for TTF. So that's 3 monitors for the PS4s, man. So that's like halfway there, guys. I don't know if you've seen my, my nerdy setup, you know what I mean? I got the fucking, this is my PS4. This is, you know, the MFC, you know, and this is the Twitch. But it's, you know, it looks like a goddamn James Bond nerd over here. But no, this is 3 meters. Yeah, this is, it's all going to TTF, dude. See, but in reality, I'm gonna miss the CRTs, man, because when I put them up for donations to the Smash community, it was like a. It was hard, but I'm gonna keep 2 of them because we need something to watch Star Wars on. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
But
if I can't go there and watch that movie, I'm never going back. Yeah. I still might not. But we'll see.
But no, like, man, like I'm just excited. I mean, yes, the you know, let me read a message from someone that was talking about the house. I'll post it over here real quick. And this is a legit question, man. And then, you know, I asked my friend, who is not my friend no more, because I'm joking. So I typed, you know, it was a joke. I put, are you afraid of the house? And then he said, not really. The house can use a lot of fixing, but I don't feel like I'm in any danger. You know what I mean? It was supposed to be a joke, and I didn't expect that from him. You know, it was K-Sexy. But hey, that's a legit question. It was like, all right.
For sure.
Yeah, I mean, it does need fixing. I mean, I do need carpet, you know, some new tile, maybe another working toilet. But hey, you know, it's my house. It's where I sleep, and it's, you know. Some people have less, and, you know, it's open for you guys to play in, you know. Hopefully we don't get, like, a tragic fire, you know, another Chicago fire or some earthquake, you know, at TTF. But, or, you know, we know, lockdown drill, you know, a house shooting. I, you know, hope none of that happens, but, you know, so the whole point of the podcast was, you know, to the houses. You know what? You got to not see it as a house on Friday. I mean... It's like, well, it's a 50-50. You still have to see it as a house and be respectful. But, I mean, treat it as an arcade, as in come out. I don't have to know you. You don't have to be, you know, super cool. Or if you want to play fighters and you're interested, hey, man, just go in the backyard, you know, watch, play casuals, call next. That's all I can ever ask, man. If you do have questions, feel free to ask me. Ask Vince, ask anyone.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people from TTF that's been there since the vanilla days. There's a lot of people been there since before the vanilla days that if you talk to them, well, obviously you're not going to know who they are because you're new. But, I mean, pretty much anyone at the house is approachable. You know what I mean? There might be a couple of, you know, characters as in, like, you know, you might run into a wild Jet Quick. You might run into, you know... A stoned out Eric Watts, you know what I mean? You might run into a couple characters, but we're all friendly and we're
Justin
all work.
The 3-day bender, you know.
You might run into an angry Justin, you know. You might run into a drunk Legati just laughing at random things. Hey, but in the end, dude, it's you know, yeah,
we're
Tim.
Mostly good people.
Just don't fuck the house up, man. Just, you know, in retrospect, you treat it as an arcade. You want to keep your arcade clean, right? You want to keep how we see it. Like I work at a school, you know. You want to keep your area clean. Because when the parents come in and pick the kids up, they say, hey, this is a clean area. This must be a clean school. So when you go to the house, you know, the house is kind of fucked up, but there's not a lot of trash. They have a trash can. They got one working toilet. They got soap. They got towels. They have a couple PS4s. You know, they have a recycling center. Hey, this is not that bad. It's not like we're eating hamburgers and throwing them on the floor,
taking a shit while we sit down. You're not smoking cigarettes in my house. It's just, it's an arcade. You come over, you have fun. Casuals are free. If you want to play in the tournament. Games.
I'm not there to eat off the floor and just roll around and shit. Yeah, man. It does what I needed to do.
And you might enjoy a bad movie or two and hang out with us. You know, you might be part of that family that, you know, the after 4 o'clock family watching a movie or two, you know, fucking
practicing the fair games, you know, practicing the fair games next year.
But hey, in the end, like the podcast has said, the pros and cons. Let's go over the pros and cons, man. So we got the pros. You're having fun. You're playing Street Fighter. You're not
or any other game. Jesus Christ, man. When's Chaos Breaker?
I'm sorry. You're playing Street Fighter. You're playing Marvel. You're playing Tekken. You're playing Mortal Kombat. You're playing Chaos Breakers. You're playing Guilty Gear. You're playing whatever fighters. You're playing whatever random game someone has on their PlayStation 3. You're just playing a game. You're having fun. You're at TTF on a Friday night. You're not out on the streets starting gang fights, doing drugs on the streets. You could be doing drugs at TTF, you know.
Yeah, the mad scientist in the backyard.
You know, that's what I really think. It's just, it's everyone's there to play games. You know, you're not going to come over and be like, look at this nerd. You know, faggot, 2015, who cares, you know. No, you're playing video games, you're coming over. Hey, you might be awkward, and you know that. If you're awkward, who cares? You know, I have friends that are awkward.
There's plenty of you people there. Legati's been living there for years.
There's so many weird people in the scene, but I mean, hey, I love you, dude.
It's all good to me.
Like, Soul Synapse, man. I don't even know anything about that guy, man. But he comes out, he plays Street Fighter, he'll post in the SD fight scene once in a while. I barely talk to him. He's, you know, kind of, I get a weird vibe from him, but fuck, he plays the Street Fighter. He's a really smart guy when it comes down to Ibuki. I have nothing against the guy. He plays Street Fighter, I play Street Fighter, you know what I mean? He loves the game, I love the game. You know, I love playing him. You know, you can't hate on people that support the community.
Absolutely not. If you're going to come out, yeah. I'll support it.
100%. I mean, if you're going to talk shit, you know, and shit on everyone, like, that's something else. That's like, man, fuck this. If you know what, there are legit, I always try to find the good part of people, you know what I mean? I was trying to find the one. There are still good in Anakin Skywalker, blah, that, you know what I mean? You know, he's still. But some people, they are truly the cancer of the scene. And I really, for the longest time, did not see that yet until recently. You know, some people, and then just like just online people, and it's like, wow, man, like, you really do not make me enjoy fighting games, man. Like, I don't understand. But hey, it's the reality though. It's like, just come over, not even to the house, to Land Diego, to, you know, in reality, like the public areas to play is probably going to be Land Diego and TTF, unless someone else opens, you know, something new. But come out, play, hang out, talk. Just don't come over, stand in the corner and pet, you know, the dog and do weird things. You know, just, you know, you got to come over and, you know, talk. And like, what was his name? Who was the Chun guy? Parham? Remember that guy?
Yeah.
What happened to that guy? That guy was so cool.
That guy was cool.
Like, he came out to Salt Mines. He came out to TTF. He talked to Richard. He talked to me. He talked to everyone. He played games, always asking questions. He donated a cool copy. He was a cool guy, and I really do miss that guy, man. And I still see him active in the fight scene, but you know what? Like I said, some of us have real lives. Some of us are superheroes. Some of us are, you know, teachers, all that, you know, blah, blah, blah. So pretty much the pros is they're there. You like playing fight, you like playing video games, come over. You like soda for $1, you know, come over. I mean, it's pretty much, you know, a late night, you know, good times, good fun. There's always gonna be people playing games.
Stay past 4 a.m.
If you play monster, like DS games, people are playing DS games. It's fucking.
There's always Monster Hunter.
There's always gonna be Monster Hunter. Oh, no, well, can't say always, but you know, people do play Monster Hunter. It's like a land center, Bert. But I'm really excited about this. This is a really good talk, Vince. Vince, before I start just talking my your head off, you want to add in some stuff, man? Some pros?
That's pretty much it, man. It's just a good place to play. There's always somebody there who's willing to grind out the game that you want to play. Almost, I've seen somebody for every single game. Just Justin, if you can ever get him out of his room to play Tekken, he'll play for Jesus Christ, who knows how long. Richard's always there. He'll play Street Fighter with you. Now that Mortal Kombat's there's Richard, me, Greg, Cody. We'll all play that shit. Like, no matter what the game is that you're going to play, Chaos Breakers, I know there's a couple people that play it. There's always going to be somebody there that wants to play the game that you want to play. And that's like one of the biggest pros of it. Like, whoever the best people on the scene, I think, will always be there to play games.
Yes.
In the game of your choice.
And mostly it's Richard that's going to be there playing the games of your choice.
Yeah, I'm sorry that you have to deal with him. But, I mean,
I'm sorry
he'll teach
that
you a lot of shit. Just actually listen to what he has to say and listen to his advice, and you'll learn a lot.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of players that, you know, look at Ernesto. DOSS comes to TTF once in a while. Hey, remember, in my heart, and, you know, I think he still is one of the top. I think he is still the number one SD Marvelhead. It's just, you know, he hasn't been playing. But you know what? I donated him five. I sponsored him for one tournament. He beat everyone. That's all I'm going to say. I really do think Ernesto is one of the best players still. Street Fighter, Richard, he will be there. If you have questions about Street Fighter, there you go, man. Richard's there. Play him a game. He even play him in Marvel. He knows what he's doing. MKX. MKX is still a new game. Everyone is still on the same level, but obviously some of us are a little better. I mean, Greg is grinding out. I mean, Richard is like trying to learn three characters. Everyone, Vince is still playing. I'm playing. I just learned that. I guess it's not. Aaron Black doesn't have the instant. I thought I was just like retarded, dude. Like, I just thought this character. So I'm gonna have to use a new Quan Chi, man. But you know, it's fun, man. Like Greg and who else is it? Marvel, Tekken, Justin. What do you mean Mortal Kombat, Justin? We'll drag him out. And if you could, you know what the true accomplishment is? If you drag Legati out of his room to play anything, then you are a true winner, my friends.
Basically.
That guy will say he doesn't play anymore, and yeah, he's not good. I guarantee you that
he's
guy will
full
probably
of shit.
He'll fight everyone but in the fight. The real Quan Chi's the shit, man. But yeah, so those are the pros, okay? Those are the pros, okay? Cons. I don't want to say there's cons, but there are cons, okay? Cons. Myself. You might not like me. You might hear different stories. I'm not even joking. This is like a real thing. You know, people might not like me. People might not like my business ethics. I guess that's the word. People might not like how I run things. People might, you know, actually think my house is a fucking dump. You know, it is. I'm not going to lie. It's a dump, but I try to keep it as clean as I can, you know. Like I said, we're not going to go into the whole, like, you know, family situation, blah, blah, blah. But I'm going to say is, you know, people are afraid to play at a house. The con is, you know, in the end, it is a house. It's somebody's house. So people might not feel uncomfortable dropping off their 18-year-old at a house that looks, you know, hella shady. You know what I mean? Like, so I do understand that. But then it's one of those things where it's like, hey, man, like, you just gotta try it out, man. You gotta try it out, you know. Give it a shot. Give Home Ec another shot, man. Okay, give Home Ec another shot. Try it out. Don't
especially
worry.
Now, like, where is there gonna be another place? We're gonna try to incorporate every single game again. Hopefully, there could be another Tekken Kitchen, stuff like that.
Yeah. Don't worry.
If more players will actually come out, if you can kind of come out and play, that'd be nice.
Yeah. Hey, I'm having two setups for you guys, man. So I don't have to like weasel a ultra setup, man. It's just. We're going to try to be an equal house. 2015, gay marriage, prop, yes on prop, whatever. But
what I'm going to say is there's going to be there's some people that from Dustloop that I'm pretty sure will be coming out at some point. So there seems to be some interest for it. I'll be there. I'm pretty shitty, but I'll play with you.
I see Toki's one guy in here.
The best
that
player in the world. He'll be there.
Where are you? I see you in here. Where are you? He's not. Oh, Mitchell, you're in here, man. Mitchell, I still want you to come out to TTF one day, man. I'm pretty sure you have some fun, dude. Zerd. Yeah, oh, thank you, Vince. Pro, we play Zerd. I haven't played in a while, but I'm down to play Zerd, man. Always down to play Zerd. Yesterday at the secret session, I saw Toki and Vincent grind it out. I mean, I think if I had to say one of our top players, if I was to name the top players of San Diego and Zerd, there are a lot of players. I would put Toki up there. It would probably be, this is just my list. It would probably be Kevin. What's his name? Shinnick? Is that how you pronounce
Chicken.
It?
Chicken, yeah.
Chicken. Hudson. And
the
Toki,
yeah.
And even yeah. I'll say Viscant, you know, I'll put him up there.
Jay up there too, of course.
And number five, I don't know, I don't know much about the Dustloop people. I've talked to them; they seem pretty cool. But from the results I see, I always like, when Toki's there, I see him getting top three. Kevin and Hudson and Jay. So you know, those are really good players. And I'm really down to throw money tournaments. I know I understand that you know, Dustloop Fridays are free tournaments. I respect it. That's cool, but I'm down for one day to like maybe, hey man, you know, $5, $10, $5, $7. I'll throw in an extra $20 for the pot. I want to see you guys play some Zerd. You know what I mean? Excuse me. Whew, that hometown buffet, man. Anyway,
sorry.
Yeah, dude, Zerd. I hope like one day you guys come out, man. I mean, you know, the salt mines is closed for 2 weeks after this week. We're gonna get into that topic later, but yeah, like, I hope, you know, the cool thing about Dustloop is they always find a place to play. You know what I mean? Like, they're never down and out, man. They're always there. I need to fix this real quick. It's bothering me. But so that, yeah, we're talking about the con. So, you know, the whole house.
Sorry, that was kind of a pro. Yeah, that's yeah. Got to deal with us.
So we're talking about the cons. Hey, Vince, can you talk about some of the cons that you might see while I try to fix this? I'm sorry. The
cons? I mean, it's a house. It's kind of basically a mess, but you have to see it as it has electricity. It has the setups. The setups all work and shit like that. And whatever the hell else is going on, you just got to kind of deal with this. That's a definite con for people, though. The bathroom works now, and it's actually clean, so I wouldn't put that there. That was one of the cons from before, I'm sure. It's kind of run a little bit lackadaisical sometimes, you know. Sometimes it's not run on time, shit like that. As of late, it's been run great, though. Those are some of the cons, I would say. It's not like one of those ones where, oh, you got to report your match, and we're right on it, and everybody's, like, running this shit really nice. But those are some of the cons, possibly. I could see people might not like that. They might not like how things are. Will says Q-man. No, I don't think so.
Will, do you have anything to say about it? Will, if you want to post in the chat, I see you back there, Will. You have anything?
Yeah, you got to wait for the stream delay to kick in, so just keep going.
You know, while we're talking about the pros and cons, does anybody – there's a lot of people in this room. We have a lot of viewers today. Anybody in here for that have any questions maybe to talk about you know, the pros and cons of, like, any concerns?
I'll give it a second.
Okay. Okay, one of the kids around 13 who went to these fanboy gaming tournaments really wanted to go to TTF tournaments, but I didn't want Cody's house to have the cops called. You know what, Ernesto? That is a really good point. That is, you know what? You do understand that, you know, this is a house, and where there is a house, there will be, you know, there might not be always rules, right? So, you know, there are nights where there's no tournament, and I just get drunk and make a fool of myself. Hey, you know, it's going to happen. You know,
it does happen.
There might be legal substances, you know, blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to say anything. But yeah, I really do think TTF is what it would be. I guess you would treat it as a bar, or more.
At some nights, of course.
Or of some nights, of course. Or maybe like an 18 and up club. You know what I mean? So like, I would say the age limit would be 18 and up. I mean, I'm pretty sure you wouldn't want to bring your mom and dad, you know, in the backyard. But in the living room,
it has happened before, though.
Yeah, it has happened. But you know, it's true that you know, yeah. But like a little kid, maybe not, man. Like. Just to be honest, I would really there might be an age limit, and then that's like that might be that's a con, I would say, because I want the future of the fighting game players to play, but that's why we preach the word of you know, the Salt Mines or Land Diego or other events, all right? So yeah, that was Ernesto. That was a good point you got, man. Really liked it. Vince, do you have anything in here while I scroll up?
Nothing to add to that, pretty much. Those are, 'cause I don't really have a problem with the place. I think it's a great place to play and stuff like that. I'm not like some of the other people in the scene that may be a little bit spoiled or want a super clean, super nice venue where they can feel safe or whatever the hell it is. This has never really affected me, so there's not a lot I can add to this, unfortunately, because I don't have a problem.
All right. Q and I don't know. I'm sorry. What about new players? You cool to having them come play since it's your crib? Are you the guy in the SCFI scene about Mortal Kombat? I mean, it might take a while, but you know what? Your question right away, what about new players? You cool with them having them come through your club? Yeah, man. If you want to play video games and you want to learn, you know, when you want to play, if there's nowhere to play MK or wherever you want to play, come over and play, man. It's an arcade. You want to play casuals. The only rule basically is, you know, just treat it, you know, it's still a house, right? That's like, you know, so, you know, don't, you know, smoke cigarettes. Don't, you know, throw your trash on the floor, but, you know, be respectful to everyone. You know,
it's like there's 400 trash cans all over the place. Yeah, anyways.
We might, you know, we might shit talk and blah blah blah, but we're not, you know, getting personal lives like how you're, you know, you have AIDS, you know, or something. You, I don't know, you know, yeah, it's.
I do though.
Yeah, stop. Testicular cancer. No, but I do.
I have three nuts.
I welcome everybody to the house. That's why I make these events public. If you notice that, I know people hate that because you get those notifications. But the reason I make TTF events public is because it's for the public. And it's for everyone in the SDFI scene. So to answer your question, I am cool with new guys coming through to the crib and enjoying the games. If you're cool with playing at a house, you know what I mean? That's all I got to say to you. I miss Tim so much, man. Number one Final Fantasy VII speedrun supporter, man.
Yeah, through all the good times.
Oh, Jesus Christ,
the Hell House Massacre.
Oh, God, Tim. Okay, going down, can I play like Legati in MKX? I don't know.
Legati doesn't play that game, as far as I know. Talk to him every day.
I love this. It's really good. Cops at the house. There's been situations where, you know, we get a little, we I would say in the Marvel vanilla days and maybe the beginning of AE for Super or whatever, whatever Street Fighter version was out during vanilla Marvel, the house, when everybody was in the backyard, it was a lot of crazy. People were screaming and people were yelling. We did get a lot of noise complaints and the cops would come. But as soon as I tell them, you know what, it's a Street Fighter tournament, and they would come in and then like, oh, okay, we'll just keep it down. You know, and that's when I have to, you know, keep it down, you know. And then they would like joke, like, you guys play Madden? And I'll be like, yeah, that sucks, man. That's a sucky game, officer. You know, I'm sorry. And fuck with them. But, you know, that was an issue. Back in the day when there was, you know, 64-man brackets, we had 14 teams of three for Street Fighter. And, you know, it was like L.A. versus San Diego. Oh, you know it's going to get loud. And I am in a little neighborhood. But and the cops would come. But, you know, everyone was cool enough to be like, you know, hey, can you guys keep it down? No one would call me a faggot or, you know, shut up. But, everyone was pretty cool about it. But, yeah, man. So that was a good one. Good one. All right. I like this. Really good. I feel like we're getting to know the people of the scene. I am always down to play MK at TTF or anywhere. Okay, Greg, shut up. You're not part of this.
Yeah, you're done. Okay. You're dead to me.
How many setups do you plan to have? Okay, Machiavelli, you know. I know who you all are, but I'm just going to call you by, you know, your Twitch names because I don't know if you want people to know your real names, Jamal. But anyway, Machiavelli.
I like in One Piece, Jamal.
I forgot it came out. I read the first two chapters, or the first two pages, and I had to, like, my boss rode by, so I had to close the window. But I like where it was going, though, dude.
Yeah, he's dead. Dude. Sorry, guys. Have fun.
What? Wasabo said was pretty badass. Dude. I have no beef with your crew, man. I was like, fuck. Anyway. Yeah,
no comment, though. Let's not make this about One Piece.
Okay, wait, I'm sorry. Yeah, I understand that. I'll treat your spot like mine. I'm not. Okay. Well, anyway. So, Jamal, your question was setup-wise. So, I'll tell you my goal for setup-wise, and I'll tell you how many I have at the moment. So, my goal for setup-wise, I want three dedicated stations for Ultra, two dedicated stations for MK, but in the end, it might be one dedicated station. So, let's go three Ultra PS4, two Ultra, two... MKX PS4, so that's five PS4s right there, guys. Just and two 360s for Marvel, and Tekken 7 will be a game, but I haven't heard any announcements about when it's coming out, and who knows? Yeah. It might not
the
come out.
Rumor was August, so who knows what that even means?
No, it might be August of next year.
It's
it
just
might
a pure
be,
rumor.
Yeah. So you know what? So if you do play Tag 2, I do have a PS3 with Tag 2, and I am more than welcome to have it. But in the meantime, there's when Tekken 7 comes out, it will be a main game. And what main games, the meaning of main game is there will always be a dedicated station. So MKX, Tekken 7, and Marvel and Ultra will always be main games at TTF. Meaning there will always be, excuse me, a dedicated station for those games. But at the moment, I only do have, you know, with the new setup that, the new monitor I'm getting from Polydactyl, I will have three monitors. So that's like, that's three out of the five I'm gonna need. So you know what? That me saying that right there, that I only need two more setups. That really is pretty cool because you know I'm that much closer to the monitor. I mean, these Asuses are like getting really hard to find, and you know I might have to buy two BenQ, you know, monitors.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to buy one also. So. We'll
but you know what? It's you know Evo is getting sponsored by them and all that shit. So, but Jamal, for your question, yes, that was the setup. That's the system. So what systems? Honestly, hey, Evo's PS4. We're going to have PS4s.
Until other words.
And if we go back to 360, it looks like I'm going to have to get some more 360s, man. Because the only reason I sold those 360s is because, you know, I needed the extra cash and I needed to buy these PS4s, man. And how many I have right now, I have one Xbox. At the house, I have one Xbox and I have one PS4 at the moment. But I do have a PS4 coming in and another Xbox coming in. And then, you know, that's what we're going to say right there. Let's see what we got here. Bam, system. We got that. Good question. Okay. Did I miss anything, Vincent?
Just this QNX guy. Treat your spot like mine, blah, blah. You should just read it yourself. It's right there.
Yeah, I understand. I treat your spot like, okay, my mind. I'm just not trying to pop up and looking at me like, who the fuck is... No, you know what? Yeah, of course, you know, who's this guy? I mean, who the fuck's that guy? Real talk. No, you know, if you post up, hey, I'm coming... And then, you know, just ask anyone, hey, do you know who owns this place? And then, you know, that's what usually people do. It's like, oh, you should talk to Cody. He's the guy that owns the place. You know, just, you know, say hello and say what's your name, blah, blah. And, you know, that's all you need to know, dude. Don't worry about it. You're there to play games. Fuck it, man. That's all I got to say.
There's been a lot of, all I gotta say is there's a lot of people that I didn't know in the beginning, and in the end, I treat them like family, dude. That's all I gotta say, man. You know,
basically,
like Fast and the Furious movie in this house every day, dude. We were supposed to talk about the cons, but these are all becoming pros, dude. But those are the cons, though. I'm not gonna lie. The cons are bad. I mean, yes. It shouldn't. I'm sorry. I think my number one con, you know, for me was, you know, the rumors. I guess, you know, people might say, you know, Cody is a shitty person and TTF is a shitty venue. I will admit that I was on the venues to avoid on SRK because of something that happened. And then, you know, one day I was on. We had a big tournament. It was a great time. I mean, we had like. It was like 40 people for a Street Fighter. This guy, we had some French guy that was living here for a while. He was there. I think LA came down. I think this is the one that Alex Valley won. I don't know. I'm not going to go into it. But, yeah, and then, you know, I got a post on SRK. If you guys don't know what SRK is, it was a really cool site back in the day that we used. Some guy from the UK, I'm in town. I heard your spot's the spot to play at. And I said, yeah, man, my spot's the spot to play at. And for you guys that don't know me, or I didn't have a phone for the longest time, and I didn't have texting for the longest time. And sometimes my phone was just so shitty that I didn't receive calls, especially if you're trying to call me from, like, you know, some number that's from some other, you know, country or planet. But basically, in the end, I guess he was trying to get a hold of me, and I wasn't picking up. And then, you know, he was trying to get to the place, and he got upset, and then he pretty much based that whole thing. The next thing I know, Mark Mann messages me. He's like, "Hey Cody, you know your name. You know TTF is on the SRK forum, the venues to avoid."
The venues to avoid. It was,
and I was like, "What the fuck?" And I see
it's
it.
You avoid that shit. You really do, because most of the time it is a lot of terrible things.
No,
like,
yeah, that
scam and stuff like that.
That site, those places where all those people really do need to go to hell.
If,
man,
you were on there, man, yeah, you're not going anywhere near that shit.
No, and then, you know what? The guy posted. I can see where he was coming from. He was upset that, you know, I told him that we always play. You know, he was upset that, you know, I didn't pick up his phone. But in the reality, I was like, dude, like, I was busy. I don't always have my phone on me. My phone doesn't always work. And then, obviously, of course, you know, I said that. And then everyone, you know, had my back. They posted, you know, I'm pretty sure you're going to fly away from the UK to play at a San Diego local, blah, blah, blah. And in the end, you know, the guy kind of apologized and my name was off that list. But no, that back in the day, that list was really, really bad.
That was death, man. That's a death sentence.
Those people were the scum of the earth. And I was on that list for one day. Or TTF was on that list for one day. So, you know, stories, rumors do go around. I'm not going to lie. I'm not a perfect person, you know, Hoobastank. We're not all perfect people. There's people that I do like and there's people I don't like. But I'm not going to straight up say, I don't like you, never show up here. No. I mean, if you feel that vibe from me, I'm sorry. I mean, if you want me to tell you straight, if you come up to me and tell me straight up, do you not like me? If I really don't like you, I'm going to say, you know, no. You know what I mean? I'm not going to fucking be a dick. I don't know what I'm saying. I lost myself for words. Well, basically, I'm saying, hey, if I have a problem with you, I'll tell you straight up. Let's say it like that. If I legitimately have a problem with you, I would tell you straight up that I do not want you anywhere near my fucking house or at the TTF venue. I ban you from TTF. I ban you from any fighting game event, blah, blah, blah. I mean, I don't have the power to do that, but I do have the power to ban someone from my fucking house and my venue. But I haven't had it done that to anyone except for one person, and that was for some other reasons that was beyond the fighting game scene. But in reality, rumors do get spread. I mean, if you guys kept up with the whole fiasco that happened a couple months back, you know, I always bring it up, but because to me it's pretty funny. But, you know, people, you know, just say, people don't like me, people spread rumors, people tell you to avoid me, you know, some people lie, some people blah, 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 but whatever. In the end, I'm here to help the community just come out. So that's one of the big cons, in my personal opinion, that, you know, rumors spread and that shit becomes a wildfire. It becomes a fire that even our new fire marshal, Wilbert, can't save, you know what I mean? And then another good con that Vince brought up is the house con. Yes, I do understand. I do have a shitty house. I do understand that, you know, the I might not have tiles. I might not have a carpet. I might not have a roof.
Yeah, just don't go in that room. Backyard is a fucking, like, just like a minefield, and there's terrible things back there. Yeah. It's basically like a forest.
Just go in the areas whatever that have setups. Never.
Yeah, just don't.
Don't go beyond the part where the sun doesn't touch. You know what I mean?
And don't walk where everybody pees.
Yeah, don't walk where everyone throws up.
If you don't know where that is, just ask.
Oh man, but to be honest, I think there. You know what? There's a lot more pros and cons. In my opinion,
there are very few cons, but I'm not the one that you're supposed to be convincing.
Yeah, I'm not. We're not. I don't have to convince. I'm just like,
I'll play anywhere. I don't give a shit where.
Yeah. You know what? Talking to, like I said, this is for the people brand new to the scene. Is that, yes, I do understand. You know, I decided to make this like a 2-hour conversation because, you know, we usually do say this at the end of every podcast. We usually do say this at the end of every, you know, tournament when me and Vince used to commentate at the Salt Mines. You know what I mean? It's true though. It's just a place to play, man. It really is a place to play. The only con I really do see is that, you know, it's a house and people might be a little
intimidated by that for whatever reason.
What's up?
They just might be intimidated by the fact that it's just a house for whatever reason. It's not just a public place.
And you just can't take my word as treat it as an arcade, you know what I mean? Because in the end, I do understand it is still a house. But pros, we all play Street Fighter. We're all here to help each other out. We all want to see San Diego succeed in the fighting game community. I mean, this is coming from me. It's like the David Letterman show, the last episode. I don't ever see myself winning a major, man. I see myself making top 32, blah blah blah, but I really don't see myself winning a major anytime soon. But I do see a lot of you in this chat room that
have it's a real possibility.
It's a possibility. I mean, anything's a possibility, right? Rada Potamus can start streaming her soon again. That's a possibility. But you know what I mean. But
I want it to be real. I want to believe.
But what I like what I was saying though is, but I do see a lot of potential in San Diego. But a lot of that potential doesn't damn it, J-Flo. A lot of that potential doesn't doesn't get seen in the light. You know what I mean? It like people don't get to see what San Diego's all about. All they see is all the jackasses. You know what I mean? So you know what? Come out, play. You need to come out and play, man. That's all I gotta say, dude. Is that I was rambling again. I'm so sorry. One of those emotional things. Vince, what the fuck was I talking about?
Yeah, you were going all over the place, but keep going and playing. Okay. You might not win majors, but there are people who can.
But there are people that can, and they're still young. I'm going to tell you the truth, man. The younger you are, the more brain power you have. When you get older, it gets a little harder. You know what I mean?
You get a little retarded.
You get a little bit retarded. You know what I mean? But in the end, hey man, just find a place to play. So that's pretty much TTF in a nutshell, man. I mean, we're all down as fuck. We're down to, you know, play, blah blah blah. So with that said, let's go into San Diego, dude. I'm still like trying to. I still want to know what's gonna happen, but we have to wait, and I don't want to wait.
It's like, yeah, me either. Basically.
I don't want to like sit at the Facebook page and keep pressing refresh like I'm doing right now. Like, just nothing's gonna happen. I got two notifications. That happened. Let's see what we got here.
Great answer. I don't even know what I said, but thank you.
Kira Demiris, blah blah. She liked the picture. That's cool. So all I can say is, what's gonna happen? I know what's gonna happen. You know what, guys? Monday I went out to the Salt Mines to play. I needed my MK fix because, you know, I decided to pop MKN play Quan Chi, and I was like, I really want to play people, so I went to the Salt Mines, you know. And of course, I'm joking, like, did I make it in time for the slot close down, blah blah blah. But then I realized, it's like, you know what, if I really do want to play on Mondays and I really want to get casuals in and everyone else does, I'm gonna have to go to like the Salt Mines after, like, right after work, man, because like that's the only time. Like, I get off like at 7. I'm everywhere all the time, dude. I'm gonna have to get off at 7, then drive, 30 minutes to Mira Mesa and get those games in. And if I want to play a tournament, I might have to, you know, weasel my way in the bracket, you know. And because if they're trying to have tournaments, you know, you're going to have to start on time. If you want to meet the hard close down time or whatever the fuck that magic word was, I don't know.
Yeah, the soft release.
Soft, hard, you know, 10 inches soft, but all that shit. But you know what?
Get at me.
We can only wait. We have to wait. We can't theory fight it, you know.
I can't
theory
see
fighter.
Into the future and see how the shit's
we
all going.
We can't see
out.
In the future.
Just wait and see.
Because in reality, it can either suck ass or it can be awesome, or it can just be in the middle.
There's no way to tell unless.
But there is no way to tell unless you come to my house right now and I got a time machine in my closet that, you know, if you guys want to check it out. Wink,
Eric
wink.
Watts is a certified time traveler. If you didn't know, and I think he's still in the chat. Just ask him about it.
Yeah, you guys, stay tuned. But yeah, so that dude, but.
All I can say is when Land Diego does start their FGC nights or whatever they're going to call it, got to support it, man. You need to support You need to you need to help your scene out. You need to, it's just another place to play. And if you don't play and you don't show support, why are they going to have it open? You know what I mean? If we don't come out on Monday and no one shows up, fuck it. Why would they give us that spot?
Why, what's the incentive for them to even do anything for us?
They should just make it a LAN center, you know, full-on LAN center. That's why, you know, we have, thank God for Dust Loop, because Dust Loop is always popping, you know what I mean? I can't remember the last time there was a Street Fighter tournament on a Monday. I'm going to be honest with you. There's always casuals, but there's never a Street Fighter tournament. I mean, but the thing is, we don't have a lot of players, man. But there's always people playing casuals, and that's always a good thing, okay? So that's all I'm going to say right now. So God bless you guys for coming out and playing casuals, man. I only played two games Monday. I beat Tong, then I lost to T-Swizzle, and I just played MK. But you know what? It was fun.
There you go.
It was really fun. And then I got the Street Fighter itch again. And then, I played at Audrix. And then I wanted to play MK. And I went to the secret location yesterday, man. It was worth it.
A lot of MK that day.
So pretty much, as we were saying, me and Vince cannot see in the future. So we don't know what's going to happen in LAN Diego. And all we can say is we only hope for the best for LAN Diego. And I will support all the fighting game scene and shit. Let's see here. So let's go through this chat room. A lot of people scared getting raped. Yeah, come on, man. It's not going to happen. Don't bring your girlfriends. Good one, Jake Songs. I want a TTF shirt. Guys, all right. We'll talk about this. TTF shirts. I'm scrolling down. So if you didn't, I didn't get your thing, whatever. The shirts are being made, all right? This is what I'm going to do. It's not a raffle because I picked the people that messaged me first, and then I tried to...
Out of a hat, it was a raffle.
I probably should have, but I already got the shirt sizes down, and it's hard to say who's going to get the shirts first, but all I got to say is, hang tight. There's going to be a second batch, because the only reason there's going to be a second batch is because I sold all the 24 shirts already up, right?
And there's already 24 more.
And then there's already 24 in the making, because I already made the profit for you if these people buy the shirts. You know what I mean? So the sizes I got. You know what? If you're listening to the chat, these are the people that are guaranteed the shirt. I'll tell you right now, okay? Let me just find this. The 007 checklist. There it is.
Yeah, the raffle list.
So this is the... Okay, I'm going to put it on because we have the technology. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we're living in the fucking 21st century.
Man. 21st century... I don't know. I feel like that's a song from a TV show.
Yeah, I think it's, yeah, sure. Let's go with that.
All right. My bad, guys. Screen reading this bad boy. Check this out, dude. Got this bad boy right here from the internet. Can you see that? All right, we can see that.
I get it for the chat delay, so give me
a second. Yeah, that's all good. Don't worry about it. Okay, so if your name is on this list, you got a shirt, basically. And if your name is not on this list, please do not worry about it. I didn't even put this on Twitter. I didn't put the announcement on Twitter. I didn't put the announcement on Instagram. So if you're any of these people and you do want a shirt, you're going to get one, bud. And so Ruben, the homie Ruben, got you a large. Andrew or Combusted got you a medium. Krom, medium. Gollum, medium. Vince, it's large, right? My bad, right?
Yeah. That's
so great. It might be in XL, but hey, you know what? Second batch might be on
it's
me.
It's like, don't, I'm not going to get another one anyways. So
yeah. Matter. So, okay, large. Maybe I'll weasel the guy in. My friend, Kevin, Toki, Joker's homie Scoot, Watts, Jason, K-Sexy, blah, blah, blah. Anyone on this list right here, there you go. You got a shirt. Please do not get offended. Do not get butthurt, because there will be a second batch. How much are the shirts, guys? The shirts are $25, okay? I wish I can give everyone on this list a shirt for free. I wish I can give everyone this shirt, this list, a shirt for $10. But in reality, it's a business point of view. And the reality is I need to make a profit to make more shirts. This is the first test run of these shirts, okay? So you guys are actually the true heroes of this shirt. Because I'm going to ask you, how do you like it, blah, blah, blah. And if it does good, we might keep it. And then, we make more money, we get better quality shirts. We get better ideas. We get just better shirts in general. Excuse me. It's, you know what? I paid a couple extra bucks for a better quality shirt. But in the end, I think the shirt looks fucking badass, man. And I'm really excited. I didn't even buy one for myself yet. Because I want all you guys to have first dibs. You know what I mean? So, $25 for a shirt. If you're a San Diego local, I don't mind. I'll drop it off to you. Swing by TTF. You can pick it up at TTF. Swing by the secret locations of any place we play. If you're there, I'll give it to you. Swing by, you know, like I said, TTF. Even, hey, I'll drop it off to you if you want, dude, for free. You know, service fee. The question, can I ship these out? Yes, I can. I don't know how to, but I will learn. For the people that want, you know, I got a couple of LA heads interested. Got a couple of people in the island of Hawaii. You know, some people in Texas interested. You know, but you know what? I will ship it. I will find out how to do it. Yes, these will be shipped out. When will the shirts come in? I don't know yet. I talked to the guy. I emailed him all the shirt sizes. It's like a 10 business day thing. I'm going to pay my cash up front, but boom, you got it. If you want to, you know, if you want to PayPal me the money, or if you want to, I'm keeping this list, obviously, because you know what? If you want to PayPal me the money, I'll cross you out. Bow, you got your shirt. If you want to give me the money up front, you got it, man. But basically, if you're on this list, hey, you got your shirt. If you don't want the shirt, let's say Alan doesn't want the shirt, then I got a large up for sale. Hey, let's say Jason doesn't want the shirt, I got a medium for sale, blah, blah, blah. This is how it works. You know what I mean? And hopefully in the end, I can get like 5 of each size, and you know, we can sell it, we can bring it around. Fuck it, maybe we'll use it as prizes, you know what I mean? And there are more shirts to come. This was, you know, the funny thing is the shirt was the second design. You know what I mean? It was the second one, because the first design was supposed to be the San Isidro one, which is actually one of my favorite ones. I might make 12 of those ones. But in the end, if that, like I said, if these become popular, I'm going to make more. I have a third shirt coming on the way that no one really got back to me on the idea, but I have a third shirt on the way. And like I said, we might make this a yearly thing. Every year, a new shirt comes out, all right? But right now, the shirt is this one, the Infinity TTF Gauntlet. It's gonna be on black. It's going to be a black shirt. So there's going to be no black ink. So it's pretty much just everything on this picture, except for the black, because, you know, the shirt's going to fill out the rest. But anyway, it looks really cool. I'm really excited. I mean, I've been talking about TTF shirts since 2009. I mean, people have always been asking. I never had a good idea for it, and then I remember, you know, this idea came to me. I mean, it's not original, but it's pretty fucking badass, and I can't wait, man. So, like I said, please hang tight. This is my first run on shirts, but I'm only here for feedback, for you know, just anything helps, man. And then, trust me, all the money goes to the profit will go to more shirts. It will go for, hey, if I do sell these 24 shirts at 25 each, there will be another PS4 at TTF. I'll tell you that right now. And more shirts, man. That's what these shirts are going to do. It's crazy, dude. You spread the word. Hey, I'm not going to Evo. Wear these fucking shirts. There, I'm there. Who's this cool guy that looks like Dr. Seuss? That's not Dr. Seuss. That's the homie Unprotected Sex from TTF, man. But anyway, I'm really excited, dude.
Dr. Seuss.
All right. So let's go down. You're going to the MKX tournament tomorrow at Fashion Valley. You know what? No, I am not going to the MKX tournament at Fashion Valley, only because it affects with my work schedule. And usually, I've been to a couple of their tournaments, but in reality, they're cool, but sometimes they're a little unorganized, as in they add people to imaginary brackets, and some try to put them in the bracket, but, you know, that's just, you know, one thing. You do play on laggy monitors sometime, but, you know, in the end, it's another place to play. And the people there are really nice. I have nothing but respect for all the people at Fanboy Gaming. Every time I talk to them, they're cool people, man. They really are cool people. And you guys should go out there and, you know, support them and give them the feedback. You know what I mean? I don't know how they take criticism or feedback. You know, they might not like it. They might not be, you know, they might, hey, you know, you don't like where you play, then get out of here. You know, I don't know. But maybe, you know what, with all the feedback, maybe something will change. But in reality, hey. You know, Fanboy Gaming, they're pretty cool. They just need to post more. When you see them posting the Facebook page, you know, give them a like. Give them a like. Know that they're being, you know that, let them know that you're, like, you know, reading these pages and, you know, that the word is getting out there. Yeah, these tournaments are at the Xbox store, the Microsoft store at Fashion Valley. But I will not be there because I get off of work when they pretty much start already. And, but I mean, Ernesto he terrorized the Marvel tournaments for a while. I think Joe terrorized the Ultra Street Fighter tournaments. The MK, I don't know what's going on in MK, but you know, Fanboy Gaming, check them out. They're on Twitter, they're on Facebook, they have a website, they're in Chula Vista. Check them out, dude. We'll Will TGF be sponsored by Taco Bell? That would be badass, Ruben Real.
Yeah, it would be pretty
cool. That would be out of control, man. I'll tell you that right now. So I'm not going to even talk about that. In the near future, no, now it will be. People should go, or DO6, people should go when Land Diego changes things up. Just tell them what we want them to do for us, the attendees. Okay, yes, Ernesto, we always say is, you know what? Like I said, I me and Vince cannot tell the future. So we just got to wait. Maybe the first day will be awesome and I have nothing to say, you know? Or maybe the first day will be shitty and, you know, here's my input. You know, take it or leave it. You know what I mean? Fuck it. If they don't budge, people stop coming and they don't get any viewers and visitors. Okay, we're going over that. TTF Tank is the best. God damn it. All right. I think I'm just going through this now. Anything serious? Everything is serious. I'm just kidding. Not those cube black chips. What's going on here? All right. So I think we're... Yeah, I think we're doing... All right. So what time does that tourney start? I don't know. Oh, fuck it. Thank you very much. Q-Nex? I don't know how to pronounce your name. I'm sorry, my friend. I'm going to say Q-Nex. But yes, thank you. 5-ups, 7-ups. So I think we went over everything. The shirts, the... is there anything we're missing that I wanted to talk about? Or Vince, do you have anything you want to talk about?
Off the top of my head, I don't think.
No, top of the head? What about the bottom of your head?
Come out Saturday and Sunday, man.
Vincent, thank you very much. Yes. Wow, I almost forgot about that, man. And that is a big part of the SDFGC. Sadly, our friend Ryan Tan cannot make it out because something happened with his airplane. But you know what? The San Diego salt mines, we're calling it the last salt mines because, you know, when San Diego takes over, there will be no more salt mines. I mean, they can say San Diego featuring salt mines, but you know what? That doesn't fly with me, muchacho. So let me find the... There we go. Okay. I'm sorry, guys. Let me just close all these windows that I can't have on Twitch and all these secret chat rooms that I shouldn't have shown on the internet.
Yeah, I got a few of those up, too, right now. It's pretty all right. bad.
All right. Okay.
But, yeah, we're very professional here, clearly. Very professional. Very focused on our work.
Very focused. Guys, come on. I know this may look like an arcade, but it's not an arcade, guys. It's serious.
Serious business.
A lot of business. None of that unfinished business, you know what I mean? Okay.
When can we expect a second batch of shirts? I don't know. When can we expect a second batch of shirts?
Who the fuck said that? I'm just joking. When can we expect a second batch of shirts? When I sell at least... when I sell all the shirts, I guess, man. Not even when I sell all the shirts. You know what? If I get enough money to make more shirts from... I don't know how much the shirts are going to cost me yet. But you know what? I'll make the second batch as soon as I can. And that's all I'm going to say, man. I don't know when I can expect it. But as soon as I can, man. Cause I want
post
everyone.
Post up whenever we know.
I'll let you know. I'll post up whenever I know. I'll let you guys know, man. Cortez, what happened to the salt mines? If you don't know, the salt mines is you know, they were gonna close down, but San Diego, which is like a PC club thing at San Diego State, they're gonna buy them out, and then you know they're gonna start running things down. Okay, so basically, Adrian and the Illuminati of the SGFGC. They got together and they talked about a new what's it called? They want to do like a big shebang, like a going away party for the salt mines, and they want to make it a 2-day event. This is Memorial Day weekend. You know, some of you guys might have plans on Monday, some of you guys might have plans on Sunday. But if you have no life, no friends, no plans, hey, spend at the salt mines Saturday and Sunday. Spend one last day. How we remember it. You know what I mean? Spend it how we remember it with no closing times, no rule. Well, there's rules, but if you know what I mean, you know what I mean, okay? So
I think you do.
Yeah, I think you do. So it's Saturday. What they want to do is Saturday tentative. Is that the word, Vincent? What does that mean? Don't know what that means. What is that? Main events or something?
Tentative could change at any time.
Okay, so these events could change at any time. So they want main events is a mystery game tournament. Okay, so they have notes. Each round of the tourney changes. Okay, so the UGF TV, right? Is that what it is? The Mystery Game Tournament? So you can be playing Smash, you can be playing Clue, you can be playing Song. I don't know. You can be playing something. So that's the main event. And then they want to have a Tekken Singles Tournament. Okay, that's cool. Then they want to do a Marvel 3v3 Tournament. 3v3 will have blah, 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 bounce teams. What the hell is this?
Tekken was pretty nice at the last Salt Mines, at the last OFC.
There was no tournament, but there was a good session. And if you guys played Tekken and you missed out on, I mean, what the fuck am I saying? Yeah, I can't English right now. If you guys
you missed out on Blake, man. That's
if
what
you guys
played
Tekken, you missed out on a good session last OFC. JR came out, aka Incognito. Blake came out. A lot of faces I haven't seen in a while came out, and there, you know, they went in the stream room and they were smart and they used the two monitors for
instead
the
of just the one.
Yeah, they didn't dual monitor it up. They used two monitors for two setups. Man, more power to you guys. A Marvel 3v3 team tournament. A Smash Crew battle. I'm hoping that's... Oh, never mind. It's not Melee, it's Smash 4. And an Ultra Single tournament, okay? So, you know, Saturday, these are all trying to happen in one day. And then there will be food served, BBQ, propane grill out on the balcony with hot dogs, burgers, buns, and soda provided. Provided! Oh, my God. Saturday after hours, Viscant Deus Ex story time. Not looking forward to that. And then we got Crom's playthrough with historical commentary game to be announced. I've heard some, you know, things about a Zerg tournament, about, you know, something going on. But, hey, you know what? This is what it says right now. And this is what we're going to deal with it. You know what I mean? Sunday events. Marvel Exhibition SD versus LA Team Wasada style. All right. So they want to do it SD versus LA, meaning that there should be some LA heads coming down. All right. That's what's up. We got an MKX tournament. Sounds good. Ultra 3v3 team tournament. You know the 3E will be there. Yep. Guilty Gear Zer tourney or speed run. Okay. Or and Marvel single. Food. Pizza. Everybody loves fucking pizza. Show shit all come. At least two giant pizzas will be provided. That means there will be two giant pizzas. And that also means that there will be a possibility that you might want to bring some $5 hot and readies, man. Sunday after hours, you know what, in the good spirit of OFC, fun times in movies, man, and that's all I can ask for. Maybe a beer or two, fun times
in
movies.
Maybe the Sunday special, who knows?
I know. Yeah, man, the last time, we'll man, fake me, we'll just burn the fucking place down, man, fuck it.
I'm going to, that was my plan all along.
But, you know what, you know what, me and Vince, we're telling you right now, we want to see everybody at this event. If you can't make it Sunday, come out Saturday. If you can't make it Saturday, come out Sunday. If you can't make it at the after hours, come in earlier, blah, blah, blah. Vis-a-vis Virgo, you know what I mean? This is the last hoorah, man. This is the last salt mines we have. I mean, it's not the last event at this building, but it's the last salt mines. It's the last late night. It's the last, you know, us. I don't know. If you guys know what I'm really talking about, if you guys know, you know, OFC, if you guys know the true meaning to Mondays, like, you know, if you know this is the last, you know, salt mines.
The last one of those,
man. That's all I gotta say, dude. I missed the OFC venue, the Bank Cortez, man. I don't even want to know how the other people feel, because, you know, they probably miss
you
it way
can't
more.
Imagine.
Yeah, I can't imagine. But if me and you miss it, I can't imagine with the other guys, man. Just all I gotta say, dude. That was a great venue. I wouldn't have met a lot of these people if it wasn't for that fucking venue, man. We wouldn't have Richard Klinks, if it wasn't for Richard Klinks, you know what I mean?
I'm sorry. Yeah. I can't apologize for that guy enough, but I'm very sorry.
That bank, dude, the bank was tight, man. If you're one of the 20 people, if you're an LA head, apparently LA knows about it. There's a Marvel tournament.
That's cool, yeah.
So let's make, you know what? Let's get some Super Street Fighter Ultra or whatever people out to play this game. Let's get everyone who plays fighting games down here and support the last hoorah of the Salt Mines. You know, I don't know if I need to mention people for people to come out. Like, hey, guys, you know, my name is Cody Denton. I endorse this tournament. Come out and have a good time. I don't know if people need that. I don't know if people need to know that Richard's coming down so you guys will have a challenge. I don't know if people.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I don't know if I need to bring, you know, I don't know, something for you guys to come out. I don't know, man. Connor may show up. But look, dude, come out. Saturday, Sunday, last hurrah, dude. Me and Vince will be there. I guarantee you that wouldn't be. Vince, will you be there?
Of course.
I'll be there too, man.
I already have a car. And I'm
that's a pro, it. Dude. That's right. There it is. Yes, you're one pro, you're one con. Last salt mines, man. That's all I gotta say. Bring naked bitches, man.
If only I had some.
I open a window. Okay, wait, we can watch that. Never mind. I shouldn't do that on stream. But,
is it what I think it is? I'm waiting for the stream delay, so we'll see.
No, it's just, oh man, but so you know, I think that's all we had to talk about, man. Now all we had to do is close it up with our, you know, the final. Let me see if I missed out on anything. When is it? This event, will TTF have a big coming back, Shazam? Probably not, but you know what? Maybe we'll make something of it. But you know what, Ruben? Just to answer your question though, Maybe I think the first May or June event will be a Low Rollers tournament. So be prepared to see that Balrog picture again, you know, every Friday, man. But Low Roller tournaments are coming back. We just gotta wait for everything. The Big Kahuna, the Big Kahuna SD is still going on. Block D is next Saturday, the 29th. That's also the start of the MKX Rambats. So we know the Rambats are gonna go into June. Obviously, just look at, you know, the SD fight scene. Look at what I post. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on, you know, Twitch. Yeah, so that's pretty much it, too. You know, this is it. This is the show. Great talking to all of you. So we're going to close it out like we always do. So, Vince, you got anyone to call out today?
Y'all got to think about this, so. I can tell you who the Ebony Goddess of the Week is, though. It's Ray Don Chong, you know, from Commando. So I can do that much, but I have to think about the who I want to call out. Yeah, get back to me.
Okay. I don't know anyone to call out. I can't. Yeah, it's getting harder and harder because, like, I really, like, Ebony, Tushan. You know what? I'm calling out all the people that, fuck it. I'm going to call all the people that don't think MKX is a real fighting game. It's a fighting game. I think every fighting game is a real fighting game. All they do is fucking complain about it, how it's not real. It's a smash for adults. I don't even know what that fucking means.
Yeah, I don't know what that means either.
Like, I'm playing the game and people are just talking shit. Like, what the fuck, dude? Like, okay, that's like, why are you? I don't know, man. It's just, it's pretty much like that. It really irritates me. And that can go for any game, as in, like, you know, like, if we talk shit for you guys playing Smash 4, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna talk shit. I mean, I don't like the game, but I'm not gonna talk shit about, you know, the players and. You know, because you guys are doing what we're doing, you know, it's just a different game. So, you know, people that pretty much bring other scenes down to bring them up, like, yeah, fuck you guys, man. You guys are retarded, man. Vincent, anyone? Yep. Vincent needs to call out. He's like calling out.
Yeah, that's basically how it goes. I always
you know what, dude?
This really good shit and I forget.
You know what my call out wall is? Is that fucker that shot the rhino, man. This motherfucker, oh, man, I can't, pretty much, there was, like, one last rhino that, like, people were guarding, and this motherfucker had the audacity to, like, he knew that, you know what, this is going to be, like, a $300,000 fine. I don't care. I have the money. And this motherfucker shot the last fucking rhino, dude. And I was, like.
That's pretty fucked up.
I was bummed out because the rhinos are my favorite animals, and I had a bunch of kids today at work was, like, oh, are you bummed out? And you know what? I was kind of bummed out because that's so fucked up. That thing was already sad enough that's the last one, man. And you gotta kill this cool little this guy right here. That's a cool little rhino. One of the kids gave me this today too, man. It's like a little rhino toy. But yeah, man. Fuck that guy and fuck people that don't like MK.
Yeah, that's good.
All right, Vince, I'm trying to help you out, man.
Let's see. You know what? I recently started playing Dota again, and I should have never done it because that game, that's like probably one of the worst games on the entire planet. Anybody that plays that game, and talks shit and just says a bunch of weird bullshit like. I fucked your mother, or those weird Russian people that don't know how to queue on their own servers, or those crazy Brazilian people that don't know how to queue on their servers either. Basically, anybody that plays Dota, including myself, you guys all suck. You're terrible people.
Yeah. Shout out to people that say good game in Hearthstone when they top deck a kill command. And
I do that all the time. But, yeah, you know, I'm one of those people also. I talk a lot of shit when I play Dota. I always say I'm from Brazil. I say give money. I say I'm a motherfucker, terrible things like that. So if you're one of those people like me, you suck, and I hate you.
But right. I am the best. I like that, man. All right, hot or not, so Vince, who got hot or not, man?
Who's hot or not?
I need to look my minds up, man.
Yeah, I'm not sure, actually.
Because I got mine. I'll tell you mine. Let me just find it real fast. Mother Chucker. Whoever this girl is, Cara Delevingne, am I saying it right?
Carolyn, yeah, big fan.
What? No, that's
good. Yeah, that's gonna be my hot or not.
She's a model. She's white, believe it or not. She was in she was in the Taylor Swift video. She was the nunchuck girl, and she's playing the Enchantress in the Suicide Squad. But for some reason, she just looks really hot in the Taylor Swift video. And apparently she's a lesbian and she dated Michelle Rodriguez for a couple of months, man.
That's what's up.
So, Yeah, that's my hot or not. Is this? Let me find it. I'll pop up the video when she pops up in it. Actually. And then, Vince, you got one yet, man? Kind of slowing me down on this fap time, dude.
I don't know, man. You kind of blindsided me with this shit. No,
you always know it's gonna be in the end of the segment, man.
No, I don't, man.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, this has never been done before, actually. So how am I supposed to know?
Or we can do the old ways. We can do girlfriends, man.
Yeah, I've already got enough trouble for that, so I'd rather not go back to that. How about Gaguni, man? Fuck it. Gaguni? The classic. That's what I'm going to go with.
All right, all right.
Even though we already know the answer, the Gaguni's hot as fuck, so. Oh, I'll put a picture up there, don't worry. All I got you guys. I typed in Gaguni, and one of the things is Kara face, so that's pretty cool.
Dude, what about Zendaya in this video, though? Cutthroat, man.
Yeah, that's next week's Ebony Goddess. So.
All right, I'm sorry.
I planned that out at least, but apparently these questions that I ask every week, I can't plan those out.
Okay, this might not be a really good picture, but, you know, this is my pick.
It's going to be good enough.
For my whatever we do. I'm just stalling right now before fuck it.
Before fap time.
Bow right there. Yeah, that's a pretty bad picture. Now, but there she is. Oh, my God. I'm playing the video, so I might get sued, but there she is, man. We'll play right there. Boom. So, yeah, that's her, dude. I pick her. The one on the, I think that's the left, stage right, Mother Chucker. She will be Enchantress, and she's hot as fuck, and she's white, which is a first. But anyway, guys, thank you for, there's a TDF shirt. Thank you for everyone that viewed in. Thank you for everybody. Another good podcast, another 16, no, after there was like 20 viewers, you know. Toki saw my other stream. I was at a good 3,000. I want to shout out those guys out earlier. The 3,000 viewers I had for Hearthstone. But yeah, man. Yeah. Now we're just mumbling. But thank you for all the viewers. Vincey, you want to plug yourself in, man?
If you want to, check me out on Twitch, Oh My Days, 138, or on Twitter, which I never post on, purple_cabbage_. Maybe I'll stream tomorrow. We'll see. Oh, wait, no, I won't. Never mind. Fuck it. Next week. Check out the Misadventures of Gerstone and possibly Evil Within resuming.
All right.
I'll see you guys Saturday and Sunday.
Okay. You guys can follow me at, you can follow this website, TTF, Tank Top Fridays, for all your Tank Top Friday tournament needs, stuff. And you can follow my personal stream, Unprotected Sex. The E in the sex is a 3. I play all kinds of shit, man. I'm usually on, from an hour or two. But I'm usually on playing Hearthstone, MK, just whatever's out, man. I play. Come by, follow, hit a like. Follow me on Twitter, Unprotected Sex and whatnot. But yeah, like I said, every Thursday now, this is the new one. Every Thursday we will have a podcast. We don't know what the fuck we will talk about every Thursday. But just to let you guys know, we will be there. And again, thanks for tuning in and dealing with our bullshit. Vince, thanks like always, man. And I hope you guys have a good night. Like I said, God bless.
Yeah, and follow Guilty. Yeah, for sure.
God bless, and I hope you guys all just make it to future events, man. All right, Vince, thanks again. See you guys later.
Bye. I'm